Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, SNL Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm trying to get on that consistent schedule. I'm going to try and get a video out every day this week. I know I've been saying that and trying to do it. Life's just been super busy lately, but we're going to make it happen. This is the deck I'm working on right now, and this is the one I think I played in the last video, or the last few videos, and I want to continue to play it and see if I can kind of perfect it. The list that I originally topped was not playing D.Va, or with this idea. This isn't my idea with like the instant fusion Book of Life into this guy. It's not my idea, but I thought it was super cool. I love zombies, and that's my favorite deck. And they weren't playing D.Vas. I think that's the main difference. They were only playing one tomato. I don't even know how I feel about playing two. Usually I like three. It's just always nice to open the play, but I think the two D.Va and another tomato is the main difference here, and I'm also not playing Wing Blast or Mind Control. But yeah, I mean, anytime I'm playing zombies, I'm definitely going to play D.Va. I was liking Malicious a lot, and I want to try and fit Malicious back in here again, but there's no space, especially if I want to keep it at 40. So I'm not really sure like what I could cut. I feel like this deck can make Stardust a lot easier. So like Stardust plus Bottomless is really good. That's kind of why I don't want to cut Bottomless, but also D.Va with Malicious is really good. So I'm not sure. I do think Malicious kind of conflicts while playing Triple Kai'Sa, though, because like one of the best plays you can do is like Instant Fusion out, Reaper of the Nightmare, sack for Kai'Sa, and then Book of Life, or banish something, then Book of Life this back, and then attack. I mean, you just go super plus and they go super minus. So, I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure if Malicious would kind of conflict or potentially be bricky. But yeah, this is never going out. I just could never see myself not playing D.Va in this deck. Everything else seems to be pretty much similar. I'm not playing Mind Control. I like it going second, I'm just not too big on it going first. It just usually doesn't do anything, and if, like, most of the time you want to be synchroing with your Alma Zombie to get advantage. And then anything else that's an issue, you just brown and bounce it back. So, yeah, other than that, like, I had to sneak a Dust Tornado in, because I feel like with the Reaper of the Nightmare play, like, the only thing you really lose to at that point is back row. So, let's see how this does. Only cards I'm iffy on at the moment are like if I want to play two or three tomato. Not opening a starter sucks really bad. But this deck, I mean, technically we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I mean, that's not horrible. So let's see. If we just brick a lot without opening a starter, I might add one in. I'm not really sure what I cut. That's a tough part. I think the weakest card in the monster lineup at the moment is definitely Sangan. A lot of the times you want to be able to start your turn with like a floater on the field. So when they attack into Sangan, like it just kind of sets you back another turn, if that makes sense. Where it's like, yeah, you get a monster to your hand, but unless you have like a Book of Life or an Instant Fusion, you're not really doing anything that turn. Whereas like a tomato, if they attack into one of these, you can just start your turn out with a Goblin Zombie. Even if they have multiple monsters, like attack turtle, get Goblin Zombie. So you always want to start your turn out with Goblin Zombie on the field. And Sangan doesn't really do that, but it does search a D.Va. So I'm not sure if I just want to cut this all together for another tomato. I just feel like Sangan's just overall in this deck is a pretty weak card. I actually want to just cut it now. The more I think about it. Because, like, if they attack into the Sangan, we're not playing Battle Traps. So if they attack into the Sangan and we have, like, a Kai'Sa in our hand, it just sets us back even further. Whereas, like, if they just attack into a Tomato, then we get Goblin Zombie, and then we sack it for Kai'Sa, or then we summon a D.Va or another Tuner. So that might be the better way to look at this. And just kind of maximize on tomatoes here to fuel the grave for Book of Life in case we don't see in case we don't see cards like any of our other floaters. Like, even opening Goblin Zombie isn't that good. Like, you want to open one of these. So, like, yeah, I don't... Yeah, you want to have either Tomato or this. And Tomato can now grab us a tuner outside of play. Like, if we open Plague before, we could get Gale, but Gale being a 3, like, you know, this deck is like, you want to make Brownic, right? So, Tomato now being able to float into, like, a Krevens, if we if we happen to open up the Plague, is nice. So, let's see how we do with this. I personally haven't missed Gale a lot. 3 is a weird number in this deck. Is this what I need to be on? Oh, okay, perfect. Sick. This is a pretty solid hand. I definitely here just want to set the tomato and just pass. Such a good feeling, right? Because, like, some people just don't attack into floaters, but a lot of people do. But even if you don't, like, they don't know if this is a Goblin Zombie or a Pyramid Turtle or whatever. So, like, it's kind of risky not to. Alright, this is fine. We actually have a really good matchup against this deck, I think. The only time it can get, like, a little... Whoa, never mind. That's a bite. Or that's not a bite. That's another layer. Alright, so this is going to work out pretty well for us here. This is pretty straightforward here. We can always take the thing. I don't want to bounce it back by any means. There's a value in just that. Let's take it. And just kind of load up our field here. Or not load up our field, but load up our hand. I think here I definitely want to just add the Plague. So we couldn't make either of these. This is probably our best choice. 1100 there. What could we send? We could send the Plague to send Zombie Master, potentially. See what happens. This could suck, but we'll see. Can't. Okay. I think we just win here unless he has, like, Gores or something. go banish. So. Okay, so that worked out pretty well. Thanks to opening tomato, which for some reason we were thinking about playing two of. So no, I'm glad that's a three. We definitely want the crows in here, 100%. Let's see, we're going second. My control could be good. I think, probably not, no. Side out dust here. Second, going second. Caius is probably not going to be that good. And we need one more card. One, two. I definitely want to keep the Book of Life in here to be able to banish some Norlaris. Let's do. I don't think this deck can even side back row if it wants to. You pretty much have to play like to Norlaris or to get Vayu stuff gone. Holy cow, this hand is crazy. Jeez. If he just sets a monster. Oh, okay. Oh my gosh, can you imagine if we draw Mystic Tomato? Oh no, he sets a back row. It's kind of annoying. It's not Mystic Tomato. What could that be? MST maybe? Weird card to play in here, though. I mean, I guess I get you're playing like Vayu stuff, but still strange, in my opinion. Part of me just wants to grab Plague Spreader, maybe? No. Just grab Spear Reaper. So we're not getting Norlaris in the slightest. Honestly, I mean, what's he gonna do? We got double DD Crow in hand. I mean, he can try and go for like the Norlaris play, I guess, but like, as soon as he targets the thing. Sure. Does he not get that yet? That next turn? I'm honestly not sure. Not really sure what this guy is doing, if I'm being honest. He must get it next turn or something, I don't know. Yeah, so maybe it's not this turn. Makes sense. Does it have some, like, can't be destroyed by battle stuff? Okay, so I DD Crow that, his turn ends, obviously. That's like horrible card to draw right now. But here, yeah, I mean, we just literally go attack over this, attack over that. He has no Vayu stuff in his grave. So we're really just chilling at that point. So, yeah, I mean, his soul release was kind of clutch, honestly. But other than that, I'm not really too sure why you play oppression in here. Just like, I guess it kind of works with that, but I don't know. Maybe it works. I had an idea. But yeah, DD Crow was nice there. So far so good. I mean, like, I don't really consider that to be like too much of a like top tier competitive deck, so I'm not gonna base too much off of that. But yeah, nonetheless, so far so good, and see you guys in the next video.